Hey, it's Sammo, and today's tip of the day, I'm going to show you how to do a content gap analysis at the page level. Now, a content gap analysis is usually done for a full domain or subsection of a site, and its main purpose is to find keywords that competitors rank for where your site doesn't. But when you do it at the page level, you can get a look into subtopics for a main keyword, which can be helpful when updating, consolidating, or even creating new content. To get started, choose a page on your site that's not ranking optimally despite having enough quality links to the page. For us, that might be our guide on local SEO. So I'll take that URL to Ahrefs Site Explorer and run the search. Next, go to the Content Gap tool. Now in the top section, paste in the top three relevant ranking results for your primary keyword target, and we'll leave the rest of the settings as is. So what the search is going to do is look for keywords that any of these pages rank for, where at least one of the targets ranks in the top 10, but our guide to local SEO isn't ranking anywhere in the top 100. Let's run the search. Now, to narrow our results to the most relevant keywords, let's set the intersections filter to only show keywords where at least two of the targets are ranking, and at least one of those targets is in the top 10. Looking at the keywords, a couple content gaps I see is that we didn't really talk about any local SEO tools, nor did we cover why local SEO is important, at least in great detail. So these are two subtopics that we'd probably cover in our next update. Now, you can also do a page-level content gap analysis before you create content. To do that, just leave the bottom section blank. So the tool will show us pages that these three URLs rank for, where at least one of them ranks in the top 10, period. Let's run the search. And again, I'll set the intersections filter to 2 and 3 targets. And now you can just skim the list of keywords and see if there are any important subtopics that will be worth covering in your post. So go and try it out for yours and your clients' websites. And if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like, share, and subscribe for more quick SEO tips like this one. I'll see you in the next tip of the day.